soldier couldn't understand why such grand king would be so excited. And why would they want to see a baby? He watched them go into the stable, and then he stood for a while longer, wondering what to do. Should he go and look inside the stable? What would he find?
The steep in path, and above him, he heard a sound. He looked up and couldn't believe his eyes. The beautiful animal flew down onto the street.
Thank you.
stable, the little soldier could not wait any longer. He knew that he had to go inside too. He walked up to the stable, took a deep breath, and pushed the door open. The little soldier was speechless. He stood there silently and stared in wonder at the scene before him. There were the kings, the shepherds, and the angels. And there, next to Joseph, was Mary sitting by a manger. And in the manger lay a tiny baby. The little soldier knew at once that this baby was very special indeed.
why he was feeling so happy. It was because of the birth of a very special baby. A baby who had been born on his first Christmas day, who changed all our lives.
Chance to glimpse a few of the rehearsals, but I didn't see the whole thing until today, so I'm very, very impressed. So what I have to say now probably pales in comparison to what you just saw, but I did want to take a minute to highlight some of the words that my friend Diego has taken out of my mouth, but some of the words that I think are actually implicit in the actions and the acting that the young children showed you today. First of all, the joy of the season, the joy that you saw on their smiling faces and in their beautiful actions and voices, the incredible giving and generosity that they are expressing to you with all their time and energy that they put into the presentation, and the hope. This is the hope that you see in the gleaming Hanukkah candles at the window and the little lights on the Christmas tree and that brightness that comes with this wonderful season in dark, dark winter those are the things that the children are offering to you and I would like to express in my own turn. Before I go on, I just want to thank you, and the last sentiment that I have for today is a sentiment of gratitude to many, many people. First of all, to you for being here this morning. I know I see many, many of you on a regular basis when I'm out in the front, but I don't often have an opportunity to thank you for the incredible support that you offer the children and our staff in all kinds of ways on an everyday basis and on special occasions like today. Thank you very, very much for being here and for doing everything that you do. So that's my thanks to the parents. I want to thank our staff who are here every day and working for the benefit of your children and who put an incredible effort in today's presentation. And I'm going to take a minute to thank a few of them individually who have made some special efforts today. First of all, you know, this is a very collaborative effort, as you can see, and every staff member was involved, but well and truly the mastermind who started